We present a practical and accurate approach for adapting semantic segmentation models using augmentation consistency. This is a joint work of Nikita Araslanov and Stefan Roth from TU Darmstadt. Our goal is to predict semantic masks for real images without any ground truth annotation for those real images at training time. Instead, we assume access to synthetic data, which is annotated but is perceptually different from natural images. The high-level idea of our approach is to exploit equivariance of semantic segmentation models to similarity transformations, which include horizontal flipping, scaling, as well as invariance of the model to photometric noise. We develop a framework that enforces this consistency using data augmentation, what we refer to as augmentation consistency. Our approach is substantially simpler to use than some of the previous works. For example, we do not use adversarial objectives, and our training does not require iterating over multiple rounds. At the same time, we achieve state-of-the-art accuracy, which is agnostic to the choice of the network architecture. To train our framework on the target data, we first draw target images using important sampling. We generate random crops and flips for each sample image, then add random photometric noise and feed it to the segmentation network. In parallel, we feed the same image batch, but without the photometric noise, to the so-called momentum network. The outputs produced by the momentum network are used further to generate pseudo-labels. We then use these pseudo-labels to train the segmentation network. The momentum network is an exponentially moving average of the segmentation network, which greatly improves the training stability. To create the input batch, we sample a number of randomly flipped multi-scale crops for a given target sample. We then simply reproject and average the segmentation maps produced by the momentum network to create a refined prediction for the original sample. We use this refined prediction to select pixels for cell supervision using an adaptive threshold. Our adaptive threshold selects a lower confidence threshold for rare classes and a higher threshold for the more frequent classes. To achieve that, we make our threshold dependent on an estimate of the class frequency. The first term in an adaptive threshold specifies an upper bound on a threshold using the hyperparameter zeta. The second hyperparameter beta determines by how much we want to readjust the threshold based on the class frequency. Additionally, we make our threshold dependent on the top confidence of the class to make it sample specific. To compute the class frequency, we first compute the average confidence in a given sample for this class. During training, we maintain an exponentially moving average of this value for each class to approximate the class prior in the complete dataset. The loss function applied to the target data is a variant of the standard cross-entropy loss. Given the prediction of the segmentation and the momentum net, the model parameters are updated by the loss that has three components. The standard cross-entropy part is simply the logarithm of the confidence value of the class in a pseudo-label. The second is the focal term that increases the influence of rare classes and leverages our class prior estimate. The third term discounts the loss if the prediction of the momentum network has lower confidence. At training time, we also sample target images with important sampling. The idea is that we want to sample the images containing rare classes more frequently. To compute the sample probability for a given image, we simply estimate its class prior and normalize it with respect to all images in the complete dataset. We train our framework in three steps. First, we train only with the cross-entropy loss on source data. Second, we use this pre-trained model to generate the sampling distribution for important sampling. Third, we jointly train on the source and target data with augmentation consistency. The qualitative results produced by our framework exhibit sharp improvement over even a strong baseline trained with adaptive batch normalization, but without the augmentation consistency. Remarkably, it even exhibits temporal stability, which it wasn't even trained for. Quantitatively, we significantly improve state-of-the-art accuracy of semantic segmentation in terms of mean intersection over union, even compared to the methods with significantly higher training complexity. This result is consistent both across the backbones we used and the synthetic dataset we used as the source data. In summary, our framework achieves new state-of-the-art segmentation accuracy, consistent in all benchmark scenarios we analyzed. At the same time, our framework is easier to use than some of the previous works, as we do not use adversarial objectives and require only a single round of training. Our code and pre-trained models are publicly available, and we hope you find it useful in your work.